Hello everyone, it's Marine for Lanfun. Thanks for stopping by. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I created this card using the brand new Flipping Awesome die set and add-ons. So first, I started by cutting the main moving piece out of craft cardstock. You can see that the die creates 4 score lines in the center and 2 other score lines to create tabs. I simply folded those 4 lines first using my bone folder, and I'm doing it in both directions. It will help the flipping mechanism work smoothly. To create my small sceneries, I cut 4 squares out of craft cardstock, 4 squares out of pattern papers from the Spiffy Specos paper pack, 4 stitched squares out of the same pattern papers, those pieces will be my skies, and 4 squares out of different cardstocks that I will use for the ground. First, I adhered each small square to a craft square. And next, I adhered each craft panel to the coordinating square. Yellow with yellow, lilac with lilac, green with green. And the blue panel will be totally glued to the moving piece, so no need to back it with the blue square like the others. Before attaching my small panels, I wanted to create a pocket, so I used the diagonal gift card pocket die to cut a nice plaid pocket that will coordinate with the Spiffy Speckles papers. The die creates score lines, so I folded them. I applied liquid glue on the tabs, and I attached the pocket to the main piece right above the first score line. Next, I flipped the main piece over. I applied double-sided tape on the tabs, making sure to cover them entirely. I like to use a small acrylic block to cut the tape right on the edges of the cardstock. I applied tape on the square part, and also on each strip. The blue panel will be my last panel in this flipping scene, so I'm going to attach it first to the square part. This square part will always show the last panel of your flipping card, so if you create something chronological, be sure to put your panels in the right order. Next, I removed the back of the tape on each strip and attached the other panels. And we can already see that it's going to look pretty good. To give a nice and colorful background to my flipping element, I used the scallop rectangle die from the add-on set to cut a beautiful panel out of the same plaid paper as the pocket. Now, to attach the flipping element, you have to fold it to be able to hug the tabs around it like so. So you remove the back of the tape on the tabs, you hug those tabs around, and you press down to your panel to attach the tabs. And then, I always like to play with the mechanism to make sure it's working perfectly. I wanted to stamp my sentiment on this white banner, so to curve it, I first taped the banner die to my work surface with the cutting edges showing. I placed an acrylic block on top of it, and I adhered my sentiment to this block following the curves of the die. It's a trick Kelly showed recently, and I thought it was just awesome. And now I'm ready to stamp my sentiment on my banner using a brand new ink called Crunchy Leaf. I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches stitch rectangle out of wood grain cardstock and adhered my flipping panel to it using one layer of foam tape. and the banner was attached using foam squares. I stamped the four trees from the tree before and after stamp set on white cardstock using jet black ink, as well as some additional images to help me create my little scenes. My idea was to create the exact same shot of the same house during the four seasons, like the ones we see in movies sometimes. You see a still frame on screen and only the seasons change to make people understand that time goes by. I've always liked that kind of shots in movies, so I tried to recreate that as best possible. When all the images were colored, I used the coordinating dies to cut them and I sorted them by seasons. I still needed to assemble some pieces, such as the snowy roof on this house and the apples on this tree. Before adhering the images, I cut borders out of the squares I cut at the beginning of the video. These borders will help me ground my scenes. So now I'm finally starting to assemble everything, attaching each season on a square using 3mm glue dots. Next, I added cute details on each square, some leaves in the fall sky, some snowflakes in the winter sky, some butterflies in the spring sky, and finally some clouds in the summer sky. We're almost done. I cut the pull tab arrow out of two different cardstocks, and I kept one arrow and one tab to create the pull tab at the end of my flipping panel. And the very last step was to adhere my panel to a craft card base. And this is the final result. I love to see this cute house and beautiful tree changing colors depending on the seasons. I hope you like it too. Have a very nice day and see you soon. Bye!